Yeah.
Weezy out of here.
A dash of digit, it's got you busy. My head in a hoodie, my shorty a goodie. My cousin's a crazy, my cousin's like boogie. Life is.
Yo, what's up? Yeah, Miles, we're out here today. Buy our cars. I know, decent bit of car content right now. If you guys can't tell, I'm trying to take this channel in a direction. But what are we doing with our cars today? Well, my car to be exact. We're doing his car later. I don't want to.
I'll show you my truck though.
Yes. So mine's in my room because. And we're back. All right. Sorry. Little interruption. So, Miles. All right. I don't hear no barking. All right, so the barking's not there. All right, so special surprise in the trunk. That's going in both. Wait. That's going in both the Honda Civic.
Honda Civic.
And the Ford Escape. Yeah. The Ford Prison Escape.
Ford Prison Escape.
Slow reveal. Da 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 da. Dual 12-inch. Subwoofers.
Yes.
All right, I want you guys to just. You can't really. Hold on.
Is it dark in there?
Yeah. Look at how perfect this fits in his trunk.
It's seamless.
I mean, perfect. And that's gonna have to fit in there.
Yes.
So, I got about 2 to 3, maybe about 3 hours. I'm gonna try to get most of this wiring kit hooked up in my car, and then either in a second part or later on tomorrow for me, about 2 seconds for y'all, I'm going to install the subwoofer. We're gonna get a sound test.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Are you rolling?
No. Yeah.
Alright, so I already opened up all of this. I wanted to look at it. I was super excited. This came in yesterday before I went to work, and I doubled. So I got home, immediately opened it. It was like 9:30, I wasn't really thinking. Hey, what's up? What we got? Oh, were you not recording all
no.
that? Oh my god.
But I am now.
Busy day. Alright, so
yes.
I opened this. This is the wiring kit. Open. We got the protective wrap to go around the wire in the trunk so it's not, you know, being burnt out. I have no clue how to use this stuff.
Amazon Prime.
Quiet now!
All the delivery trucks are passing by.
We got the power wire here. This is what we're mainly going to focus on today. Thing is, though, is about here. We're going to have to cut it, and I don't have the proper equipment to cut it, and we're going to have to install the fuse. Nice little fuse. It's only plastic. I would not put glass under the hood.
Nah.
And then we got power wire, and I'm assuming the speaker wire. Because that's 16 gauge.
Focus, though.
And then extra parts. So this is what we're focusing on today. And Miles, I don't know if you want to pop your trunk again. We'll show them what else there is to install on a later date. We got the amplifier. Which, if y'all don't know, this is what makes the boom, boom, boom. So, might get to this today, but I might not. I might wait and just focus on wiring today. And then we got the line out converter. This is basically going to take the speaker. Since we both have stock speakers, this is going to take the speaker, or speaker, the stereo output, and I'm just going to convert it to where we can adapt it to the amplifier. And then bass controller, which is in here, and the big boy.
Yes.
I gotta figure out how I'm gonna keep my bike and that in my car.
Yes.
So, I'll probably pull up a video just to make sure I'm doing this all right, but as far as I remember, you gotta take this. My car's nice. Positive, right there is the Garmin to go to the back of the car, so that'll be nice and easy. Now we just gotta figure out a distance to cut for the fuse, and I'm thinking just so we have some extra to play with, I might cut it like right there.
Yeah, but you want like the least amount possible to the fuse.
Well, you don't want to chop it here.
No, no.
But you don't want to chop it like back here, you know?
Yeah.
So I think it's somewhere like right about there so that there's a little bit of playroom just in case we screw anything up like cutting. I'm going to double check on the video though. We'll be right back. All right, so this is going to be a little bit tricky. Ugh. So we got to pull. There's a little tab. There it is.
Let me get a look in there.
I'll pull it off so you can see. We got a little tab right here that's on the back side. You should be able to see the sunlight coming right through. A little bit more up. Might want to take the tripod off. Nice. There you go, right there. So we got to run the wire right through that.
Under the dash.
So, I'm going to do that. We'll be back.
Bong.
All right, so wire got through. We literally got like maybe 3 feet here to work with. And I'm not complaining. That's, you know, less of everything. I was not expecting it to be that little. Let's not touch it to this. As I do it.
Just added an explosion.
All right. So now we need to take this and poke a little hole through. Got my little trusty knife. Just take it right in the center.
Oh, you're gonna get demonetized, Drew.
I know, I got a knife out on YouTube.
Gotta use a box cutter.
I ain't got no box cutter.
We'll just make the knife a box cutter. It's a box cutter, guys.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then we just gotta stick. Gotta love shoving big things in little holes.
Oh, your battery's turning blue again. It's hard to get your face and everything. I have to stand back.
Yeah.
You like that high angle, though?
Yeah. Whatever really works. I mean,
I think it makes the video look better.
All right. Are you rolling?
We've been rolling.
Oh.
Gangsta.
So we got the garment through. Just going to slide it back. We don't need to, you know, tuck it away or anything just yet. Back to the video. This is where the choppy happens. I'm a little bit worried. This is like a one-time go. So I'm going to say I'm going to chop it about, if it's going to sit about there, I'm going to chop it about here. No, here. I'd rather chop more than too little. Oh, God. Whew. Moment. Oh.
Pretty thick wire.
There we go.
Goes.
Oh.
How does she look?
Not super clean. What was that? Not just that.
Oh my.
X amount. I'd rather do too little to start. About there. Alrighty, so here's the fuse. I don't know anything about the fuse other than it's a fuse. We got this hole right here with this Allen key that will hold this wire down. You have to strip the rubber away so that I can make connection with the wire on the inside without dropping it. You're going to take it and insert it. Take a number 4 Allen key and tighten it on down. Now, I would say you can't over tighten, but you could definitely under tighten. Don't crank it down, but you know, something like that, something where you can, you know, pull on it.
Yeah.
Now, there's a little bit of wire exposed on each side, but that's okay because we have
the casing.
The housing. Yes. And there's our first step in installing, well, second step really, but one of the steps in installing the subwoofer.
Woohoo.
So now we just gotta run the power cable to the back and we'll go from there.
Booyah. It was a wild Ramirez. Yes, in the wild. I'm going to say hi to him. Or attempt to.
Oh, go.
And the tape.
So it's not an important step. I just don't want this to, you know, be moving around while I'm trying to, you know, re-thread this wire through. I need you all to see how perfect this is. There's literally a perfect spot for the wire and the fuse to sit right there. Tell me this car was not meant for an aftermarket subwoofer.
That's a clip there.
Oh, I lost one of these
there
pieces.
There goes that door.
All right, time for the rest of this.
Mira's, run. The car's coming. Don't get hurt. And hello, who is this? Oh my god. I thought he was gonna run me over.
Oh, I can't play it because it's gonna be copyrighted.
Oh. We got editing.
Hey! I just ogred myself.
God, I am.
Oh god.
So there is a 10 millimeter bolt right here that is a negative wire. I probably should have disconnected the negative at the front.
That's literally what the first instruction says. I read the instructions yesterday. It says, disconnect
the... How do you take the negative off on this car?
Wait, let me get on video, boy.
There you go. Thank you.
That did a pretty good job.
And we put that in our bodies. So we got that to negative battery cable. I hope that's negative. That's what they showed in the video.
Let me turn it on and rev it.
Move, Miles. One end of this from the back of the car, and then we need to run the other end to the front. These are the RC cables, or the line from the stereo to the amplifier to actually send the signal of what to play. So, Jake, hold this then. Yep, you never want to run the wire on the same side.
That's stupid. It's gonna be lit.
My battery's gonna die.
Mm-hmm. Get me the camera.
All right, so we got the power cable connected to the fuse, ran through the Garmin. Jake showed up. We got it, ran through the firewall along this side, back through here, and into the trunk. It's not wired, ran perfectly, but whatever. And then we got the negative battery connected to the negative wire connected to the negative ground here. We have the RC cables ran from the trunk out.
Wait, remote control cables?
Along here, and into the front. Now, I don't know what to do. All right, so now I need to run the RC cable up in behind my glove box through here and leave it there for now. And I need to get my stereo off, which is gonna be a task. All right, so we pop these off at both the top and the bottom with a tool that has now gone missing. We pulled all the bolts out from the stereo to where we can now move it. We should be able to.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Oh. There's a stereo right now. This is in the way a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Do you want to show them the current setup we got going?
What is that?
That is something that we're going to need to get to. I just don't remember which, but yes, that is the backside of my car in stereo. Show them the setup outside as to how we're doing this in the Florida elements.
Good boy. Florida elements. Let's go.
Not in the rain.
This is what we got going on right now. Jake is still operating, so he can...
Alrighty, if it'll autofocus, me and Jake busted the stereo out just to show you guys... So these are T-taps. Basically what happens is you fold
in,
it,
boys.
That metal prong will close the wire. Oh no, there's still one more bolt. So there's two bolts down here. So you take a wire and you'll put it right here.
Oh, I see it.
You'll close this and that metal prong will just cut into the wire. And then you take one of these ends, whatever you want to tap into, you'll put in there. Squeeze this metal clamp down. It's really, really hard to see. And then this metal prong right here will slide in to the back side of a closed T-tap. And you just tapped in. We ran the blue wire up into there, and I'll show you in a video, but my RC output converter is tucked up in there. Stereo works. So, what I was not expecting to be able to do today is connect the amp and the sub and play my very first song. This is going really, really smooth. Maybe a bit too smooth.
I'll just start explaining.
Is it rolling?
Yeah.
All right. So, somehow I've got mostly everything done. And I think I might be able to get this all done today. So, I'm in a bit of a rush, so it kind of goes to crap. There you go, that's why. But I mean, if I could get this done in one day, I'd be really, really happy. I mean, tomorrow I'll still have to tuck all the wires and everything, but that's not a big deal. I could probably do that a little bit at school before I go in and just finish it up at home, and yeah. So it's going to be loosely put together today, but what's REM? All right, so I need to cut this cable, and I'm using my very, very, very not sharp knife.
No, it's a box cutter, Drew.
Yes, I'm using my very, very not sharp box cutter. All right, so battery positive. Put it in the hole. Miles, has this just been one long clip?
Yep.
Oh, God. My poor brain while editing this video in like 2 weeks when I actually go to edit it, because I don't edit my videos in a timely manner. So we're hooking up the battery positive, which is not hooked to the battery. I will say that. I have not hooked that up yet. Oh, that's perfect, Jake. Give it a nice little tug, make sure it's in there. Now, we got the grounding wire. We're gonna go ahead, and I don't have the proper equipment to do this, which is clippers for this, so something like that. Go most of the way through, something like that. Go most of the way through. And then we take the knife to finish off our imperfections. So that's fully cut, that's fully cut. Now it's just a quick jerk. Oh, no, there's a litter. Can you zoom in on that and see if you can't see that? Look at that little itty bitty bit that's holding it all. Is there another one? Yeah, I could probably just, boom. All right, grounding wire. Slide it into the hole.
Wait, there's something sticking out.
I don't know if I need the REM hookup. I don't even know what that is. Crap, which is left and which is right?
Do you want me to get the box? It's in my car.
One should be red, one should be blue. I think red to red, which is red, white, or right. Miles, can you go grab your instructions?
Sure. Hold this.
All right. Hi. A five. Oh shit. Oh my god. It was meant to be.
Wait, does that match the exact same angle too?
Yeah. Just about.
Let me see.
It matches the angle almost perfectly.
Yeah, a little bit of wiggle space, which is nice for the wires.
No, you got.
Where's that light at?
Oh, this might be the REM controller.
Yeah. I don't think you need this stuff.
I don't think I need that. I think
I
just
need the input, this. Right?
Yeah.
What's that for?
This is the speaker wire.
You need to, you know there's like wire cutters in the,
I have
like,
wire cutters.
Like specifically for that.
Yeah.
Heck yeah. Heck yeah. I think it's the same as an IV.
Wow, that works really, really well. Oh wait, that's what this tool is designed for. Like, literally is what it's designed for. Alright. Blue is positive. Oh no, blue's gonna be positive, yeah. Alright guys, so I am currently hooking up the speaker wire. I'm running blue as the positive, white as the negative, which makes no sense because the other ones, the RC output converter was white positive and then black or gray negative. Yeah, that's how it was. But you know what? It is what it is. Bye bye.
Someone's excited.
I think we're all hooked up. I think all I have to do is hook my negative battery terminal up. Oh, wait, one more step. Come over here, Miles. We can't forget about the most important step. The bass control knob. What was I thinking?
So where are you going to put that?
I have absolutely no idea.
I would keep it on the driver's side.
It's sitting there for now.
Bullshit. Your lights.
I know what I dropped. I dropped this, which is very, very important.
Toy.
Yeah, I need that light because I need that part. Like, I actually really, really need that part. So you know how most of the time it's a 10 mil for your battery? Oh, that's tightening, I believe. Right? That's loosening?
Yeah.
You know how it's most of the time a 10 mil for your battery? No, not Ford. Let's be 11. That just makes a lot of sense. All right, guys. This is either where I'm going to blow my entire system or this is going to work.
Yeah, I think you need to take off that one.
Good idea. There's no power currently being ran to this, which if I did everything correct...
Do you know what size bolt you need?
No. If everything worked out right...
I'm going to stand back a little bit.
This should...
It's
not even on.
Power's not even on.
Drew, the power's not on.
Really?
On this. On the amp.
Do I have to like turn it on? Alrighty, I know the exposure is pretty crappy and everything. I had to go to work. We didn't get it. I forgot one wire, which is the remote turn on. So we're gonna do that in the pitch black. Let's see if this works. Alright, so
I like holding this
one. The blue wire, the REM wire. We need to run this. Oh my god, Jake. We need to run this from back here to the front. I know cable management's a mess.
We'll do that later.
Is it rolling?
Yeah, boy.
All right, so we're about to connect the REM source. I definitely didn't just start my car without this even connected to the amp, because you know I would never do such a thing. Gosh, there should be light.
Let's check it out, boys.
All right, there's power.
We have no power. Except for that sounds very different. Like, that's kind of creeping me out. Can we turn that off? I don't like the fucking sound of that shit.
Day two. We got it hooked up. Now, what I had to do was I had to go out and buy the camera wheel. I had to buy a fuse tap. It's basically a T-tap, but for fuses. So, in the video I was watching, the guy used that to run the REM or the remote turn-on wire to the amp. Come on. Exposure. So, we got the power on. It's on.